while back, I was eating lunch with some coworkers, and we were debating about just how far you would sink if you jumped into a pool of these water balls. For example, would it go up to your calf, or to like your waist, or all the way above your head? Everyone seemed to have a different theory. In fact, I asked about 100 people, and you could see how much the guesses varied. So as a firm believer in the scientific method, I decided to test our hypotheses. So I am here today in the backyard of the backyard scientist. So for the past 6 months, we've been stockpiling these water balls in Kevin's backyard, and today is finally the moment of truth.
Yes.
For this?
Let's do it.
So take a moment to guess in the comments below of how far you think we'll sink, and then we'll see if you're right. For the record, I think I will sink to about here. Okay, here we go.
Oh my gosh.
This feels so crazy. It just feels like compressed on all sides, but it's so smooth and like slippery. So it looks like I was wrong by quite a bit, and we have to reject the null hypothesis. So, now what? I decided to call up my nephews.
You guys wanna come swimming at my friend's house?
In my ongoing quest to be the favorite uncle. Only I might have forgotten to tell them there'd be no water in the pool. Also, that Kevin was right there.
You guys ready to go swimming in this?
But before we go swimming in 25 million Orbeez, let's talk about why I was wrong.
It has to do with buoyancy, so here's a riddle. When this ice melts, will the water level go up or down? As you can see here, it actually doesn't change at all. Archimedes taught us that you displace your weight in water. So this baseball weighs about 135 grams. And when I put it in water, it will sink until it has pushed out 135 grams worth of water. At which point it's in equilibrium and it floats. And since the water line is about halfway up the baseball, you know it's about half as dense as water. And this is why Scooby-Doo quicksand is pure lies. You sink until you've displaced your weight in quicksand, and since it's about twice as dense as a person, you bob like a cork about halfway down and it's impossible to sink. So Atreyu, relax, your horse is gonna float. So I will keep sinking in Orbeez until I have displaced my weight in Orbeez. And since they're a little more dense than me, and taking account the packing efficiency of a sphere surrounded by water, the fact that about 85% of me sank makes sense. I thought the friction between the balls would play a bigger role, which is why I guessed halfway, so I was wrong, but a lot of times that's more fun, because that means the result was unexpected and you learned something. Okay, back to the pool.
Back in there! Come on, man! Come on!
Oh,
guess where my foot is. Huge thanks to Kevin for letting us use his pool. He actually also made a video.
We did 8 crazy experiments with a pool full of water balls.
So go check that out, because his footage is amazing as always.